In this video, we're going to look at how we can sort and filter our data just to start doing some simple analysis on it. As you can see, my Olympic athletes file is currently sorted on total medals, but we can sort it on any of the columns that we've got. And as always with Excel, there's a couple of ways of doing this. The first one is to click in any column that we want to sort on. So for example, if I want to sort by athlete name, I can just click anywhere in this column, come up here to the sort and filter menu and select sort A to Z. And we now have all our athletes arranged in alphabetical order. Now the behaviour of this sort and filter menu changes depending on the data in the column you've clicked on. For example, if we wanted to sort by age, we click anywhere in the age column, come up to this menu, and we've now got smallest to largest and largest to smallest. Likewise, if we click in the closing ceremony date column and come up here, we've got oldest to newest and newest to oldest. So you can see that's dynamic and it adapts depending on the type of data you're selecting. Now the other way of applying a sort is to do a custom sort. Select the custom sort from this menu, and in here you can select any column in your table. You can sort on the values or various other options in there, and you can determine the order that you want to sort it in. And you can get quite detailed with this and put custom lists in and things like that. The other thing you can do here is you can add additional levels of sorting. So what I mean by that is we can select our country here, and that will sort all our athletes by country A to Z. And then I can add a level and say within each country I want to sort the athletes by the athlete name A to Z. So if we apply this, you can see that we've got our athletes neatly sorted by country, and then within the country they're in alphabetical order. And you can add many levels to that. The other way to access the sort menu is actually through filtering. So if we apply a filter to our data, and we do this by clicking anywhere in our table of data, coming up to our sort and filter menu and selecting filter, you can see that that's added these little drop down arrows next to every single column header. What these drop down arrows do is they give us a shortcut to the sort functionality. If for example we click on the athlete one, you can see we've got the sort A to Z, sort Z to A, and sort by colour. And what the sort by colour does is actually brings you to the custom sort menu, and that's the one I've just taken you through. The other thing we can do with filters is we can select a subset of our data. For example, we might want to look at every record pertaining to Chris Hoy. So if we start typing Hoy, you'll see that this is adapting the list below to our search criteria. Now we've got two records, we've got Andrew Hoy and Chris Hoy, so we can just unselect Andrew. Press OK, and we've now just got the records relating to Chris Hoy. The other nice thing about this is it gives you a neat little count at the bottom, so it's telling us there's 4 out of our 8,613 records that relate to Chris Hoy. So just to demonstrate the value of that, I'm going to clear this filter, and to do that we come up to the athlete drop-down and select clear filter from athlete. So if for example we wanted a quick count of how many athletes had competed in the Athens Olympics, we'd come in here, we'd select Athens in our filter, click OK, and you can see that 1,839 of our athletes competed in Athens. If we applied filters across multiple columns, so for example if I filtered and picked everybody who was 20 when they competed in Olympic Games, and then everybody who was 20 and competed in football, we've got three filters applied now, so we could clear them by coming into each drop down individually and clearing the filter. But a quicker way to do it is to come back up to this sort and filter menu and click the clear button here, and that clears all the filters from all the columns, so you're back to your complete list of data. As always with Excel, you can also do a lot of these actions through the keyboard shortcuts. For example, in order to apply a filter, all we need to do is press and hold CTRL and SHIFT on the keyboard and then press L. And you'll see that that's applied the filter to all our columns. Similarly, if we wanted to remove the filter, CTRL, SHIFT and L, we'll toggle it off again. Another useful keyboard shortcut is just doing a really quick sort, maybe A to Z or in ascending numerical order. And to do this, we press and hold the Alt key on our keyboard and then press H, S, S. And you'll see that's immediately sorted our athletes A to Z. If we then moved into a column with numbers in it, for example our age column, and did the same keyboard sequence, so that's press and hold the Alt key, H, S, S, that's now sorted the numbers in ascending order. To do the reverse sort, so for example, athlete Z to A, or age oldest to youngest, we again press and hold the Alt key and press H, S, O. And if we want to quickly access that custom sort dialog box, again we press and hold the Alt key and then press H, S, U. And that box pops up for you. And if we quickly apply a filter to our data, for example, if we select everybody who competed at Athens again, and if we now want to clear that filter, again we press and hold the Alt key and press H, S, C. And that's returned to our full list of athletes. If you're often applying filters to your data, you might want to consider putting your data in a table, because this gives you the filter functionality out of the box and also a lot more besides. I've done a whole video on reasons to use tables. Please head on over there to have a look, because they really do save you lots of time. I hope you found this video useful. Please do like and subscribe to my channel for more Excel tips. Thank you for watching.